Hi, it's Frederick again, here for a new episode of What's What. First thing first, before starting anything, don't forget to subscribe if you have not done it yet, because there is plenty of exciting episodes to come about electricity. On this stormy special, we are going to talk about lightning. I will show you how lightning is formed. I will debunk some myths. Who knows? Athena may stop by to explain how lightning forms in the atmosphere. Are you ready? C'est parti! Oh no, excusez-moi. Everyone is French in this studio, I mean, pardon my French. And my English. There is no party. We can begin. Now, we all have heard about that one famous experiment by Benjamin Franklin, no? In spite of the myth, Mr. Franklin did not get struck by electricity, nor did his kite or his son. If they were, the experiment might have turned ugly. But Benjamin Franklin did achieve his goal on this stormy night in June with a kite, key, and jar. With these simple objects, Benjamin was able to capture an electric charge. This was a huge moment in the history of electricity. But what I am wondering is, how does lightning form in the sky?
That's my cue. What's up, Frederick? I heard you were having a party.
Very funny, Athena.
I'm just kidding. Your English is fine, dude. But anyway, we're going to be talking about lightning. And what better place than come to the lighting district of New York City? Lighting, unlike these light bulbs, is actually a natural phenomenon that happens in a specific type of cloud. This cloud right here is known as a cumulonimbus, aka a thunderhead. Get it? Thunderhead. It's actually a dense vertical cloud that is caused by a buildup of electrical charges inside that eventually causes lightning to strike. Now, lightning forms in this specific type of cloud due to two natural phenomena: gravitation and convection. That's a lot, right? Don't worry, the lightning won't come just yet, Frederic. But spacesuits are better. Now, what happens inside of these clouds is there's actually a combination of ice and water. And the water pellets fall to the bottom of the cloud that are heavier. And, well, that's because of gravity. But this is where the convection part comes in. There's a difference in temperature between the top of the cloud and the bottom of the cloud. And this causes a change in airflow within the cloud itself. This causes an interaction between the particles and the pellets, causing friction, which then causes an electrical charge and eventually lightning. But why does lightning target Earth? Well, the electrical charges found at the bottom of the cloud are negative. And what does everybody say? Opposites attract. So what does the negative charge attract? The positive charges here on Earth. You see, these negative charges form a type of magnetism around them. And when they go to target Earth, they immediately look for the areas on Earth where there's like the closest area to the surface. And suddenly, boom, lightning strikes. Pretty cool, huh? Hey, are you still there, Frederic?
Yes, Athena, I'm here.
Okay, awesome. Do you want to hear some more fun facts about lightning? Well, near Lake Maracaibo in Venezuela, it can thunderstorm up to 300 times per year, striking about 28 times per night. How crazy is that? Now, this is due to the lake's unique shape and the air conditions. Oh, and you guys should totally research mega flashes. The longest recorded one was 16 seconds in Argentina. So cool, right? Oh, and by the way, guess where all of this data is collected by?
Space satellites?
Oh yeah, there are lightning storms in the great beyond too, like on Jupiter. The lightning storms on Jupiter are 10 times stronger than those here on Earth. And if you guys think that's scary, look at Venus. Venus doesn't have water in their atmosphere. Instead, Venus has sulfuric acid. Imagine a lightning storm caused by sulfuric acid. Can someone say scary? Yeah, but that's only for space cadets to worry about. Thankfully, us Earthlings have a lot of safety precautions that we take into account, such as lightning towers, ooh, or lightning rods to protect rockets. Maybe you could talk about that, Frederic. I'll see you next time. Salute!
Goodbye. Her French is not so good. But she's right. Lightning is drawn to the highest and most detached parts of the Earth's surface. Lightning towers are built to attract lightning bolts and redistribute their shock to non-detrimental areas. Here we have a FET open laser lightning rod used to protect a space shuttle. This one carries electricity down to a grounded, which absorbs impact. You have heard lightning never strikes in the same place twice. That is not true. In fact, lightning rods are built to draw lightning to the same location. And guess who invented lightning rods? We'll give Mr. Franklin credit where credit is due. But a Frenchman, Thomas François, actually captured lightning first. Even with lightning rods, lightning can be very dangerous. When lightning strikes, a surge of current creates radial voltage along the ground surface. The currents are often more damaging than the strike itself. They can harm us, create electric interference within the power grid, and damage other electrical equipment. Very scary, I know. I'm okay, do not worry. I should have expected that. You ever wonder why we hear thunder after lightning? It's because light travels at about 300,000 kilometers per second, while sound travels at about 340 meters per second. This is a much slower rate. We see the lightning bolt instantly, but the sound of thunder reaches the ear much later. To assess how far away lightning is, count the number of seconds between the flash and thunder. Then divide by 3, you get the impact distance in kilometers. Wow. 1 kilometer away, not too bad. Remember, lightning is a natural phenomenon within the cumulonimbus cloud. Moving ice pellets and water particles create friction. The friction produces an electric discharge, lightning. Lightning is drawn to the highest and most detached parts of the Earth's surface. Stay grounded, my friends. Well, that's it for today, everyone. Remember to stay safe in the storms. Subscribe, give a thumb up, leave a comment, and stay tuned for our next episode of What's What. It will be electrifying. Guys, can I remove the suit now?